What is going on, everybody? This is Kyle, Dillon, Lynne.
I'm tired.
Mr. Mimikyu.
Hello.
And if you like our intro video and our outro, here's the man responsible for it, Mr. Seth right over here.
Oh, this man.
And we are here at Hershey Park, as you see pandemonium right behind us. I cannot believe we're here.
I can't believe we're here.
I'm telling you.
I'm so far up north.
I'm telling you, this has been an incredible...
Farthest north we've ever been, all three of us.
It's been an incredible couple of days. We had 2 days at Busch Gardens Williamsburg, which were amazing. Had an amazing night, an amazing day at King's Dominion yesterday.
I'm still feeling the effects of King's Dominion.
I'm telling you.
That ending was just a meme and a half.
My knees.
It's all part of the fun.
Exactly.
So, and I'm kind of like their park tour. I've been used to go to Hershey Park all the time. It's been years, though, since I've been here. So definitely a lot of things have changed over here. I know Candemonium got open for the last time I came around. But back when, that was Sky Rush was the newest thing. That was probably like the last time I've been there. No, that was the laugh track that was like the newest thing.
So you guys are ancient, basically.
I am ancient.
Oh, good lord.
He's ancient. What does that make?
You're not,
what am I?
Yeah, what
you're
does that make us?
I don't want to know.
What does that make Seth and I? I don't know. But
fossilized.
Boy, we've known these guys for a good number of years. This is the first time I've met Nick and Seth in person. I know Dillon, you've met Seth.
Both of them, actually, yeah.
Both of them, okay. So this is really cool.
Been a bit with Nick, but of
not
course
really
Seth last
you
year.
You met me before. We were at Daytona like a few years ago.
Yeah, like 5 years ago almost.
Yeah, I know.
Jesus.
Not sure what we're going to start out with here, but...
Maybe Fahrenheit. Maybe at least get something out of the way. I don't know.
Sounds good to me. So.
Either that or Laugh Track. I've seen that Stormer's closed right now, so I hope it'll reopen eventually.
So before
at least
we
we'll get something like all five of us can ride.
So before we get started, Dillon, you want to do the typical business here?
Well, of course. We appreciate you guys checking us out from all of our WeTheCoasters juries out there. And if you've enjoying everything you've been seeing, Williamsburg and King's Dominion, then of course here, hit that like button and subscribe if you're brand new. And of course, hit that bell notification. Without further ado, enjoy today's feature presentation.
There you go.
So we started out on Lightning Racer. Not bad.
Yeah, we did Lightning as the first ride there, so that was good, and we won.
And we won the race, yes. Nick, yeah. You said the first time in 11 years that
yes.
We finally got a victory.
The first time in like 11 years I've been here at Hershey Park, I finally win one of these Lightning races.
All right.
Yes!
Yeah, the ride had a few bumps, but other than that, it was a very good ride. You could tell it's early GCI with the way how it was ridden there, so that was nice. That was not bad.
Not bad at all.
But we're going to definitely do it again. We're going to try Thunder out, see how that is from there. But I noticed they retract the lift.
Actually, you guys got it wrong. We were on Thunder.
Or, I mean, oh yeah, we did. Wait,
nope, we were on Thunder. Now we're going to probably do Lightning.
Yeah, you're right. But I did notice they retract both the lift hills, though.
So that was good in the front row. I would imagine if you were riding in the back, it probably would have been... We're going to turn this man into a coaster enthusiast
weekend. I'm trying. Testing the waters.
All right. Yep, time to do the other side, I'm guessing. So.
Okay, we just did the Lightning side of Lightning Racer, and we totally got screwed out of the victory.
Yeah,
that's fantastic.
Did we really finish ahead? I can't tell.
We barely. I feel like we did. Two people to the back row, which is Lynne and Nick, and
awfully brave.
Hey, you gotta feel the whip, man, on the wooden roller coaster.
Oh, you feel it.
You'll feel it. That's the experience, though.
I'm kind of surprised that wooden coasters don't collapse with that kind of rough.
Oh, you'd be amazed.
Yellow Pine, I guess.
All in all, not a bad ride. I felt like it was a little bit bumpier on this side than the first side.
But. Yeah, for like an early 2000s GCI, not bad.
Alrighty, well, where to next?
Left track,
alrighty.
Yeah, because it was like very slow. It was kind of underwhelming, like middle.
So we just got off Laugh Track. At least the three of us did. These guys just ditched us with the first opportunity.
So we can't help it. We were popular too there.
Yeah. Jumpers.
Yeah, right.
Fun ride, a bit of an acid trip inside, but what
do
you
expect? I mean, it's a fun house.
That's
expect.
Fun mildly.
Yeah, the queue was interesting, and then the ride itself was also very interesting.
It's fun starting out going facing backwards. That's always a...
Yeah, me and Lynne faced forward in the beginning, and then, like, our spin was kind of... We got some spin, not too crazy. How was your guys' spin?
I got previous spins.
We got spins.
Yep.
Oh,
yeah.
Man, that sucks.
Spin!
All around, very, very fun,
right?
For
something much bigger, though. I think so.
Wow, Pat's revenge.
Yes. This time?
Yes.
Finally, let's go.
Let's do this.
The last time I rode them.
So,
don't remind me of that either.
Wildcat's revenge.
The four of us did it.
Awesome. great.
Nick and I rode in the front row. These guys rode in the back row.
Row was unbelievable.
Man, the restraint system and the ride-offs are definitely putting this at A tier.
Yes, you can pull down on your lap bars. Thank you.
They don't even check the seatbelts. They're like, oh, it's buckled? Okay, pull down.
Yeah. The other thing, too, the seatbelts are definitely very different, too. There's like a weird different seatbelt look, too. So yeah. not upset about that at all.
Not a metal.
Yeah, it was...
very different.
Then in the front row, you said the inversions caught you off guard.
It did. I will tell you that. I mean, you would think it's a left one coming up, but no, it just goes you a full on right.
Oh, like, yes.
I almost twisted my thigh doing that. Because usually that's the way you counter it.
Mm-hmm.
But no, if you know it's coming.
All in all, I don't know what I like better yet. Maybe if we swap
the roles, we'll figure it out.
Yeah, definitely.
Honest opinion though, the stall is my favorite inversion.
Yes.
The airtime pop, as far as that one is, it was definitely the airtime pop. Literally, that just happened right there. That one there was really good.
I avoided getting stapled, but I feel like the bar kind of kept going down slowly but surely throughout the ride.
Yeah.
So, he knows what you're doing, buddy.
So, yeah, we got a couple of rough airtime moments, but all in all, really good.
A little bit.
A couple other things, too. There's a middle thing you can hold on to, and then there's different things on the side to hold on to. So instead of, like, one, like strap to hold on to on the side that you're in, like regardless what seat you're in, you get like
and
two things on there. It's nice.
Racing for dear life, not knowing where to hold on or just putting your hands up, which is not really
no, it was good though.
For people who have not ridden RMC before. They definitely give you something to hold on to, which is definitely an upgrade.
Yeah, it was very good though. Very, very good.
Agreed.
So what are we doing next? I have no idea.
Maybe
if
I will be.
Very nice. Well, sounds good to me.
Unless you want to do the wild mouse.
Why not? Let's do Wild Mouse.
Alrighty. Sounds good to me.
So we're over here where you can get a refill, and Lynn has a bottle here.
Alright, so I found one of these. They were like 24 something after tax, and you get unlimited refills all day. After today, you get refills for 99 cents. Now, show off, that's like really, really cool. Alright, we're gonna wait for these ladies right here. So as you can see, it's a little self-serve thing. You scan this little QR code right here, and then it'll time the machine for 20 seconds to let you refill it. If you don't have a refill, I think it'll charge you somehow or something, but I don't know. We're not there yet, but we're gonna try it out here.
Now you said every 20 seconds, right?
Not every 20 seconds, but you get like 20 seconds to refill your cup.
Oh, okay.
It's highlighted right here.
Interesting, but
yeah, it's
a rather different system at least.
Yeah,
it's definitely self-service.
So looking at the products, we got Pepsi, we got Mountain Dew, we got Starry, we got Bubbly, Tropicana, Brisk, and then just regular water. So interesting choices there to say the least. No Dr. Pepper though. That's very weird though.
I saw Dr. Pepper at one of the other locations. I think the one where she got it from had Dr. Pepper. So
here we go. So we scan this, authorize.
There it goes.
21 seconds. You gave it 21 seconds.
Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and
do
some
dirty. It even tells you how many ounces you put on.
Yeah, that's
too.
Crazy.
That's really
5 seconds.
Great.
Let's try mixing it up here.
Wow, look at that. That's it.
Wow.
And that's it.
23.1 ounces there.
It's like watching a pit stop in action.
Yeah,
interesting.
So we just got off of Wild Mouse. Boy, what an original name that is for a coaster.
Yeah, right. Honest opinion, probably the best of like the traditional ones.
Yeah.
Really good.
Really good, a little bit janky, but not the worst one I've ever been on by any.
There was a funny thing, like, so me and Lynn were in one of the trains, and then Kyle, Nick, and Seth were in the other train, so like, we're doing our thing, and then they're going up the hotel, and it's just like, they're going up, and we're going for the, they're like, hey! So it was just great interactions all in all, too,
yeah.
So. And operations were like the best one in the Wild Mouse I've ever seen, period. Unbelievable.
They are booking it here at every road
we've
been
to. Like, were you seeing like other ones? Like, how bad were they?
Slow.
Like,
pathetic.
What do you mean, like, slow?
Oh, just stop the car, load in, and take like an extra minute.
Yeah,
it's terrible.
You just have to keep moving.
Yeah, I wish all wild mouse would be like that.
Yeah, that'd be great.
And this one is like a conveyor belt. They use
awesome, amazing.
I don't know how old this ride is, but
hoping not that old, but still very good though.
It's pretty smooth.
It's not that old, I don't think. I don't think they ever redone it when I was here.
No. I'd like to point out too that Lynne mentioned earlier. So there's a piece of the original Wildcat near the entrance of Wildcat's bed. So it's cool that they made a mod for that. That's actually the first time I've seen that in general because I didn't know the thing.
It's a very nice.
I caught it.
Well, I mean, like when they showed it.
Yeah. So of course, you know, people were sad to see it go, but it, it was due for a repaint, reconstruction. Yeah, I'm talking about NASCAR now, apparently. But yeah, that seeing that track up there makes me feel like I'm like 50 years old now because that's been there ever since I was like way young. Me and my dad were going on it all the time.
Now it's reborn into a wood steel hybrid.
Yeah, he would love this. RMC. If my dad was here, he would love it.
But yeah, really cool though. Good ride on Wild Mouse.
They should have done Cheetah at Wild Adventures, but no, they just decided to tear it down.
So are we doing that big blue and orange one right over there?
Oh, possibly.
Alrighty.
All right, just got off Fahrenheit, and I have to say, that's been my favorite ride so far today.
Wow, that ride was amazing. So good. Right now, it's like probably the second best ride I like in the park there, but nothing wrong if you think it's the best ride, though, so far. Very, very good. Loved it.
Glad you guys love it, because it's literally one of the best five roller coasters here. Like, you guys haven't seen the juicy parts yet. Yeah. We're only getting started.
Yes.
Lynne?
I'm excited. Definitely a unique experiencing double chain lift.
Yeah.
That 110 degree drop wasn't as bad as I was expecting, but still fun nonetheless. By the way, you did not hear copyrighted music, YouTube. Do not demonetize.
Yeah, there was one random vibration in like one area, but other than that, it was really good though.
And as always, you have to have a 90 degree straight up and then the 110 back down. That's the thing about Fahrenheit, it's so iconic.
And speaking of music, yeah, hats off to whoever's in charge of the music. They played a lot of good stuff today.
Yeah,
the Man in Black, we heard Zach Brown Band.
They're mixing up between old and new. Like they really are. They're not sticking to one, you know.
We heard some 90s country over there, which I approve of. So good on whoever's in charge of the music. They're doing a hell of a job today.
We're here to accommodate everybody. Yes. That's what we do here in Hershey.
There you go.
All right, we are about to do Storm Runner. I
know you are extremely excited
about this. Oh my god,
this.
I'm so pumped for this, man. Fun fact, it just turned 20 years old this year.
So, it's really 20 years old?
It is.
This is literally top three. If you're liking launch coasters, this is definitely the one for you.
I'm going to be honest here. I'm a little bit nervous about riding this one.
Well, the main reason, too, is not just the launch, but the crazy version, the flying snake dive, which you're not going to see it, but it's hidden behind the trees over there. But, oh, man, it's going to be awesome. I cannot wait.
I think I'll be good once I get past
some ground down here.
And for sure, I have to do pride. We have to.
All right.
Yeah, me and Dylan.
I think I'll be fine once I get past the launch.
So you may see Seth filming us going on the ride, so hopefully we'll see you then on the ride.
Yes.
You'll see.
Words.
He's gonna die.
Good luck, all.
Kill the conquering heroes.
Oh my god.
Well, you're all still in one piece. That's good news.
Yes, we are, amazingly.
He's alive.
Yes.
He is alive.
I was quite nervous when riding this thing, but that was awesome.
Well, the good news was wherever it ended up going, Dillon was going to be there first.
Do what?
Wherever it was going to go, Dillon was going to end up there first.
Exactly. So, that's...
Man, that's one intense launch, man. Holy cow. That was unbelievable. Wow.
Yeah. Better than Maverick, I'd have to say. Better
easily.
Whoa, we got to fight.
Stormrunner will take this any day of the week. I don't really care. I've never even been on it. I've been to Stormrunner many years. I've been to Hershey Park long. Wow. I can remember. This is as good as it gets.
Most intense launch I've ever been on, period.
Plus, you guys ended up getting, maybe a better launch because you waited for a while.
Yeah, they were trying to get someone on the train because they were stuck. So
I don't know if that builds up.
Yeah, there you go. Oh, you're good.
So I don't know if that builds up the hydraulics anymore or not.
I don't know. It was fun though.
I really thought that launch was gonna like punch me in the gut, but it really didn't.
No,
it kind
of
did.
More of a flow launch in a way.
Yeah, it was just a lot smoother than I thought it was gonna be. So
it looks
nice.
It looks like
it's definitely more power than a regular LSM or LIM.
Yeah, and we got lucky because it's actually drizzling a little bit.
Yeah, I was noticing that. I'm like, they're getting a rain ride.
Not really a shoe rain ride, but hey, this is fun though.
I will call it a
drizzle ride.
Drizzle ride. Yeah.
So, anyways, off to the next attraction we're gonna do.
So we are currently in line for Comet, and the line is moving a little bit slowly here, so I guess they're sending out the band to entertain people.
It's one train operations for the new Comet out here.
Oh, Lord of mercy, as we're moving up.
But this is not just any Comet, this is Comet with the new trains and restraints that yours truly here got to see at IAPA back in November.
Oh, nice.
Yes, so I don't know how well you can see it over here.
I'll probably lift up on your head. But these have individual lap bars now instead of the buzz bars, and they have a nice blue and gold train that's right out here. So it's very nice, I can see. We probably see it first once we probably like get off the ride and all that, but it looks very good though when we show you that. But in the meantime,
we got a bit of ways to go waiting in line though.
Yeah,
downside. Oh well, we'll enjoy our wait and enjoy the band that's down there.
So we just got off of Comet. Interesting ride there, not too bad.
Yeah, it's a very interesting ride overall, but the thing that was amazing was hitting the brake point and getting off the ride. That was pretty comical.
Wheel seat by accident, which I really wanted to point out, but I thought...
Yeah, so for those of you that don't know, you ride a wooden roller coaster. Every third row is a wheel seat, and that's going to be the roughest part of the ride. So,
we felt the bumps on that one.
I bet.
I could ride that coaster all day, though.
Oh, yeah, very...
I bet. He could have rode front with Nick because Nick had no one with him. But
yeah, I know. The guy said I had an imaginary your girlfriend.
I thought he was riding with John Cena right there.
It's not bad of a ride, though. No. It wasn't bad. It's got an interesting layout, like a layout I've never seen before. I think it was like a D-shaped layout. But not bad, though.
So I think about half of us are going to go ride Sky Rush right now.
Yeah,
unfortunately.
If Dillon was half, then he would be able to ride.
Wait, you want to see me go on Sky Rush?
I would love to if I wasn't so tall.
So, all right, we're going to go do this. I'm looking forward to this one.
So we just did that right there, the super duper looper.
That was
super
duper.
And we have to start out right here. Seth, your very first coaster going upside down.
Yep.
How was it?
It was good. It was good.
You did it.
I think if any coaster to actually start out with, to get used to it, this one.
Yes.
Because I can do this one again and again and again.
Just a single loop. It works right.
Yep.
Very similar to Scorpion over at Busch Gardens Tampa, but way smoother. Like, it feels like a B&M. That's how good it was.
And me personally, I love this ride because it goes to show you, you do not need those hard over-the-shoulder restraints for a looping coaster.
No.
As Great Bear goes by us.
I know. Great Bear's so loud, but that's old school B&M. It's probably going to pass by in a little bit too as we explain something, but oh man. It's great to know how smooth it is though. Just love it interrupting.
It's been known to be an oldie but a goodie. Yeah. This has been the first looping coaster here in Hershey Park way back when my dad first started coming here back in like the 70s or whatnot. This thing is a legend of the park. It's an oldie. There's only one loop at the start, I think, but it's a goodie, I promise
yes.
you.
Yes.
Yeah. Now, I gotta say, I coached him a little bit on trying to go upside down. I'm like, all right, Seth, here we go. Ah! He got a little worried, and then like after the exit, he goes, I can do it, yes! Yeah. I'm like, oh my god, yes, I've done well.
The funny part was I didn't mind that drop either.
No, the drop it wasn't bad.
Yeah, at first I didn't really care for the stomach drops, like on B&Ms and whatnot. And it took me a while to get used to it. And as you guys probably know, Velocicoaster was the one that actually made me like get rid of coaster anxiety. I don't know how, but suddenly after Velocicoaster, I'm fine.
Yeah.
I don't get nervous about stomach drops.
But no, I just want to say I'm really proud of him. He's definitely worked his way up, and I mean, he's now
bit by bit,
slow and steady, man. Who knows? Maybe. And I'm just saying,
like I said,
a few years from now, he'll probably be doing stuff like Great Bear and all that.
I'm doing what I feel comfortable enough to do.
Right.
Like I said, we're going to turn this man into a coaster enthusiast before the end of the weekend.
That's going to be awesome.
I mean, hey, there are at least three now that I've ridden here that I'll say I'll ride again.
There you go.
That's awesome.
So we were, before this, we were going to ride Sky Rush.
We had an intimate moment.
Yep, we had a good old classic intimate moment. It is back up and running, so we're going to go try that again and then probably get something to eat after.
Like I said, Kyle, Lynne, and Nick are going to be able to do it. Unfortunately, I got to sit out and These two don't want to ride it, so
we'll
it's totally fine.
We'll also show you, probably, saying that, like, you know, he's just an inch too tall. Just like on Falcon's Fury.
I'll make an early prediction before that happens. I think she's going to be blown away on this ride. Mark my words.
If scared was a height, I reached that.
Okay. Oh, my God.
Alrighty, let's go do Sky Rush.
Okay, so we just got off of Sky Rush. Boy, we had the...
You two and
well,
you.
Yeah, me,
this
Lynn,
guy,
and Nick.
This guy, me, and Hi.
And, yeah. Boy, that was a pretty fun ride. Yeah. We had to wait quite a while in line.
Yeah, how about,
yeah.
Hold on, how about you guys talk about the ride experience first? Why not? May as well.
That
yeah.
first drop is incredible.
Man, it the is, cable lift was super quick.
Yeah,
it is very quick. I mean, it's not Storm Runner quick, obviously, but if you're not prepared for the initial, like, height, like, even just being... I kind of wish the camera was, like, right towards that, that incline, but that's a really steep incline, and you're not going slow. You're going fast up that hill.
Yeah.
I admit, I was a little intimidated, but ever since that first hill drop, perfectly fine. If you can get over that first hill, you're going to be fine. This ride, I will say this, compared to when it first opened, when I was first here, it is a lot smoother than it was back then. Because
really?
it was very rough at the start.
Wow.
So it's gotten a lot smoother.
That's good.
Definitely
this,
for sure.
This coaster just got brand new restraints this year.
Yes,
so.
that could also be a factor.
This happened a little after announcing comments. As Great Bear goes on by. So they changed the over-the-shoulder restraint with an over-shoulder lap bar. It used to be like a T. Now it's like lots of coasters there.
It's very comfortable.
Yeah. So shout out to Intamin. They at least, you know, fixed that issue because it was very polarizing. It had the nickname Thigh Crush for a reason. Yeah. Reason there. And also new signs, new station colors and everything too.
And we also had an interesting moment happen while we were waiting in line.
We had somebody
just getting off the ride, and he decided to jump over the gate.
Which, by the way, I'll have you guys know that there was a separate line for the front row. So he really just, like, skipped the whole entire beginning of the queue and also the separation.
Yes.
Especially the front of the line. Like, you know. So, what did we do, Kyle?
Well, let's just say the ride operator in me came out here because, you know, we see this crap all the time at Kings Island. We don't put up with that.
Unfortunately.
So we get up to right where him and his party are about to get on the ride. So I decide I'm going to tell the ride operator. And right next to the ride operator happened to be a supervisor at that ride. I told him what happened. He went over there and talked to him. Out of the line he went.
And that's right before he even, like, got on the ride. So
yeah, he really just
waited, like, an extra 15 minutes or so. And you're thinking, oh, boy, I'm going to get another front row. Nope, you're not.
So don't come to an amusement park and line jump. We do not put up with that crap. And I will call you out on it every time. Whether I'm on the clock at Kings Island or just visiting a park as a guest. Yeah. We're not going to put up with it.
I don't care if it's to fill up a row. I mean, if it's just a few people, okay. But you just really hop the fence and skip the entire queue line.
After just riding.
The whole thing. Plus, you skipped in front of the entire front row line.
And
that's not okay.
After just getting off the ride. So he already got a ride, and he was going to try to, you know.
Yeah.
Skip an entire line.
Exactly.
No, meanwhile, there was somebody a couple of rows back. Not really rows, but... There was somebody all the way in the front who only had a party of two. So I put two fingers up and I say, party of two, come up to the front.
Yeah, and you're trying
to
do a good deed.
Yeah, I mean, it's a good deed to fill up the rows. Mm-hmm. And it's like an unexpected surprise. It's just a couple of trains that you don't have to wait for.
Right.
Now,
that's not
like that
jumping.
Guy, that is, no. You skipped the whole entire thing.
Separator will do that.
I'll just say it's separate enough. Look at the line right now. It's completely dead.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
But I just want to start up.
Yeah, a little bit. See you guys. So I just want to say this real quick from WeTheCoasters. We're not here trying to be bad people. No, it's just like, guys, it's simple enough. Don't try to line jump.
Yeah,
that's pretty cool.
Somebody here that works at an amusement park, yeah I'm going to get you
that's
every
horse.
Time. So if you're going to be a Karen, I don't care.
Yeah, that's horse. Don't do that. That's extremely rude and disrespectful.
You know?
Yeah, no. Somebody at, it wasn't White Bar Canyon. It was over at, it was Busch Gardens. And it was the Whitewater ride.
Oh, Congo.
Yeah. Congo. Somebody just jumped the whole entire line. Like some kid walked through the quick queue line and jumped to the front with his friends.
Yeah.
Now, we kind of had to let that one go because he was so far ahead. But basically, we were booing him. Yeah, we shunned him. basically.
Yeah, we've been dealing with a lot of people this whole trip.
If you launch up, you are going to have a lot of people like whisper behind your back and shun the heck out of you, all right?
Yeah.
Nobody wants to be shunned,
all right? And some people might be ballsy enough to tell our ride operator and get your ass out of line.
Like this guy right over here.
Thank you.
But I'll tell you this, though. I mean, we want to at least end it on a positive note. I mean, all three of them got to do the front row. We had a couple people with us that have been hanging out the whole day, and just want to say thank you to everyone here. Which, I got to say, hung out with us the whole day. Well, most of the day, I should say. Even though he didn't do any rides, but he was hanging out with us the whole time, so I appreciate Andrew for joining along. He put the weight.
Hey, I was glad to meet you guys. I mean, hey, coming up from Florida, good to see you guys. I'm only 30 minutes away, even though I have nothing to do with roller coasters, so I don't belong on this channel, but you know.
Nonsense. You enjoy all the technical stuff. There's no such
Everybody
thing.
Everybody belongs. It's family.
Exactly, yes.
Absolutely.
It's family.
You rode Skyrush. One up on me.
Yeah, okay, exactly. Yes. I have ridden Skyrush in my life. That was the worst experience of my life.
Aww.
It's because I can't handle that stuff.
But no,
thank you guys for having me.
Yeah, no problem, man. Thank you for coming around, man. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for everything,
thanks
man.
Thanks for coming to my theme park.
Alrighty, I don't... I think
Yo, MTV theme parks. That's how it is.
Alrighty, I think we're going to go get something to eat now.
Yeah.
It's been quite a while, so who knows?
Let's do it.
So we decided to do a ride on Trailblazer, which is an aero mine train. And,
probably one of the smoothest ones I've ever been on.
Yeah,
that's impressive.
I was in the back. Me and Nick were in the back, and it felt pretty smooth back there for the most part.
It did. It's pretty smooth. Trailblazer is not meant to be like a huge thrill ride of a coaster here at Hershey Park. It's meant for like, you know, I would say more like a younger audience, A or B. Like people that are not like, you know, very keen on roller coasters, but kind of want to have some experience anyway of Hershey roller coaster stuff. I mean, if you're like a beginner trying to get on the roller coasters, Trailblazer's for you.
Yeah, definitely. I was really worried that the thing was going to be extremely janky, but no, that was actually quite comfortable. So,
Kyle, to point this out, so we went underneath the flying snake dive or storm earlier, so probably the best version of the ride.
Oh my god, that was amazing.
Oh, yeah. Oh, these guys are going to have some fun. So this is by S&S. They're all known for drop towers and shoot-up towers. But, well, these guys are going to go up.
Upsy-daisy they go, and then all the way back down.
That's how it goes.
Fun. Bye! I've been the ones that just really up and then drop.
I think this one also brings you top two. Oh yeah, it drops you as well.
I'm trying to focus on the room, sorry if it's not, so.
Don't go on that with a full stomach.
I know.
Oh man, look at that hydraulic kick in there.
Just when you think you're done.
10 out of 10 would recommend.
Yeah. Oh, calm down, I've done. I don't trust it.
Okay, only at Hershey Park will you see a vending machine that has milk. Now, I approve of this.
That is awesome.
And as Dylan pointed out before I turned the camera on, our friend of the channel, Crystal Palace, pointed this out in one of her videos last year when she was here.
Yeah, and you can also get chocolate over here, too, which is incredible.
But look at that. King-size Hershey's cookies and cream.
Yes.
Go for that. Those are amazing.
Then we got dipped pretzels as well from Hershey's cookies and cream, and Reese's, and king-size Kit Kats.
King-size Reese's peanut butter cups. Those are classic. I love those. Look at this giant Rice Krispie tree right
there's
there.
There's something behind the party mix. I'm trying to see. Oh, it's a hot fries. Go figure. It's hidden behind it. How does that work?
Now these prices, I really don't know.
$2.
$2, okay.
Well, the king size are $4, but the other stuff is $2. The pretzels are $5.
Oh, I see them right there, okay. But this is interesting. I've never seen a vending machine that has milk.
Now, funny enough, I'm not gonna drink it. There is one of the milks here. It's actually at the top of there, but.
So you asked the question, got milk? Yes, they do.
So, was it you and Lynn that did it?
Yep.
Yeah, where's she? She's right here.
Okay.
Yeah, I know these guys, they didn't want to do it. They got a full stomach and stuff. It's like, nah,
it just did one of the drop towers. It just did one of the drop towers here. I'm just kind of not feeling it right now. I don't know if I'm just...
Guess which one. You can already guess.
The biggest one.
Of course.
Of course.
So I'll tell you this, the restraints and seatbelt were very comfortable. The seatbelt's a little weird, but the restraint was nice. It wasn't bulky or anything, it just very, very comfortable.
Also, the drop power is pretty unique. Instead of going all the way to the top and then dropping, or like shooting you up and then dropping.
Yeah.
What it does is shoot you up just a little bit. Well, shoots you all the way up, then drops you, like kind of bounces. Then it goes up further, all the way to the top. Drops you and then slowly
yeah,
goes
we'll get a view right over here. You'll see it in
first
yeah,
there you go.
But I asked Seth, I go, you have room for more? He goes, nope.
And just like that, the park is closed. You see, it's all smooth right there.
Yeah, what's amazing, you can hear the hydraulics big time on that thing. It's unbelievable. Oh, the air compressor.
There. Very good ride. Very, very good ride. We're trying to do a vlog. Come on.
Personally, I would rank Falcon's Fury on top and then this one as my top favorite drop powers, I'd say. So once that Cedar Point, of course, they are pretty big, but I mean, not very, I don't know. One that shoots up and then one that
not very forgiving,
you.
Maybe? I don't know.
So not really forgiving, but just not interesting, you know?
So with that, the park is officially closed.
Day one complete.
Put it into day one. It really flew by today. And,
wow. Storm by Rajna.
Great coaster right there.
Oh, man, I believe. We missed a few rides,
yeah,
which was Great Bear.
Pandemonium and...
Jolly Rancher.
Yes. So we'll get those three eventually,
rides,
and we'll get the other rides. Yeah.
Three rides, but then we can go ahead and ride our favorites and enjoy the hours.
I'm a fan of these hours, closing at 8 tonight,
yeah.
Closing at 7 tomorrow, and we're in the June now.
To be fair, I mean, these guys wanted to, you guys wanted to wait in the front row of CI Rush, in all fairness. So.
Yeah, and unfortunately, it had an intimate moment while we were waiting in line, and then it finally got up, and then... Yeah. Yeah.
But you know what? We all had a good time though, regardless. So yes. It was great. Now, I want to say, Seth, come on over here real quick. Because I know this technically was all of our first times, with the exception of Nick. How was your first time here?
I enjoyed it. There were a lot, like half dozen roller coasters that I haven't already done.
And your first loop?
Yeah. First loop, so.
Incredible.
Which I actually found out is an inversion. I thought a loop was a loop and an inversion was an inversion. Apparently, it's an inversion.
Potato.
It got after me.
Going upside down. Like, for example, the info sheets would say inversions. It would say it goes upside down goes looping or whatever.
Right. Now, I'm just going to say this. For my trip I've had so far, I've had a blast. It's been really, really good. I know we did, like, one thing for each of the rides, but very good, though, nonetheless. The park's nice, but definitely has one of the weirdest layouts I've ever seen.
Yeah, the setting's interesting.
It is. It is very interesting. But I still had a lot of fun. It was great. Staff was good. And I don't know really what else to say. I don't know if there's really anything that they really need to add that there's something missing, at least to the tip of my tongue. But for the most part, everything that's out there, you got what you need. So
it's got a wide variety, everything.
There is.
It's been my first time being back at Hershey Park in, like, I don't even know how long, honestly. It's been, like, at least, like, 4 or 5 years.
That's true.
But, yeah, getting to know the park again from the inside out, I mean, they have everything for everyone here. It's a great amusement park. That's why I go here every year.
I think it could use an under the sea ride.
Oh my god.
I mean, yeah, because of that band play.
Jesus.
Yeah.
How about Lynn? How about your first time here at Hershey? What did you think of it there?
First impressions are definitely a must or an important factor with finding an amusement park to go to, and it definitely. I'd say that it would meet expectations. It definitely didn't disappoint me, and it didn't wow me at the same time.
But it was still a fun park.
Yes. And in fact, I would, if I had the money, and if we had the time, like maybe once my mom retires, like, I want to take my parents up here.
Yeah.
That's how it is, honestly.
So hopefully, like, when day two comes around, we'll probably get the rest of stuff that we missed too. Yep. That's
like
the other thing.
My parents, when they were growing up and dating, they did Kings Dominion and Busch Gardens Williamsburg. They didn't go as far up to those northern Six Flags parks or the Ohio parks. Or even Hershey Park, so I'm actually the first one the family to be visiting here.
They're jealous of you, man.
And, yeah. Also, it serves Pepsi, and we're Pepsi people. Yes, I am dating a Coke guy, but...
What is this garbage?
Nah, they had Dr. Pepper very rarely, which is kind of a little discretion thing. It's a...
We don't give away the secret. That's the main part there. But, yeah, so that is it for day one here at Hershey Park. I gotta say, so far, it's been great. We'll be back for day two, but until then, we will see you guys later on for day number two here at Hershey Park. As you gotta love these towers with these characters.
They're trying to talk!
Stay tuned for day number two coming up right about now.